So, first and foremost, man, who is rapping ass DJ?
Rapping ass DJ. Rapping ass DJ, Wang Tay DJ, Umar Muhammad DJ, Devon Boston, all the same shit. Just me shit. I just got the name Rapping Ass DJ because, like, that's all I cared about doing and shit. Up top, like, doing my time, just writing music and shit. So, everybody knew me by DJ, like, Rapping Ass DJ, nigga, always rapping and shit. So, that's how I got that name. I just stuck with it.
So this 35th and Jackson and shit, this is where I grew up at. Come on. This house right here and shit. I grew up in this house and shit. You know what I mean? And then I ended up moving to this house. You know what I mean? Right here. 35th and Jackson, you see? It's another house too, I ain't gonna put on camera. My grandma's still, my family still owning this shit. But this is my block and shit. So yeah, you know what time it is.
Came up to be a nice young man, man. Everybody out of town respect rapping ass DJ, AKA One Tape.
Yes, sir.
Smart guy, very, 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 very smart. Hey, if Ron DMC, them list to this, Rakim, all them, MC Shine, all the young brothers too now. Everybody got their swag. But hey, this is the guy.
For real. Everybody gonna be the craziest stories and shit. Hey, yo. My email is Tupac Back. That's in my fucking iCloud. It's Tupac Back 2K17. The year Tupac died and shit, that's the year that I was born. Man, shit. I like feel like Tupac a lot. I understand Tupac. Tupac, nigga, he was like, nigga, he wasn't scared, he didn't fear, and he wanted it. Everything that he got, he deserved. He wanted that shit. You know what I mean?
Alright, you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready, bro.
The real deal.
So, the GPS is taking
work. Yeah, go to the GPS. Yeah, you can go to the GPS. Holla ticket.
Kansas City is the town.
I'm doing my blick, you know I'm thugging that strike. Uh-huh. Catch me OT, I'll probably throw you a hustle. Out in Fort Myers, I lock you in off the muscle. Hey, when I'm out in Miami, I know some pirates getting them in, they smuggling. Only niggas from the Midwest out there plugging.
I could be all the way on the East Coast again before I drop it. It's about being smart, but you, a rapper wouldn't be smart. Man, that nigga ain't open this shit, man. He ain't open up to shit, man. He gotta open up to be open. For real, I want the cats out here.
I need this platform. You can put one that don't jump on shit.
You don't want to, like, just walking around? Like, that? I actually want the cats. Okay. That's my alter ego.
Hey, when I'm out in Miami, I know some pirates getting them in, they smuggling. Only nigga from the Midwest out there plugging. Baby Drakey under my Tommy in public. Designer belt, Timberland boots, that ain't nothing. I'm off Boom Rock, so off a nigga, I ain't stunning. I grab my Philly shiesty blick and go hunting. Real estate, and I got that game for my cousin. Shout out Florida, they who got a nigga buzzing.
Hey, and we shooting a documentary right now. Straight shot in this bitch.
Straight shot.
We most straight definitely shot. Coming up. Holla, turn it down. Say something on that bitch.
What's up, Wayne? Dr. M.A.G., TSG, killacity, all that, you know?
All that shit.
Yeah, that bitch on that.
Nigga, the realest niggas gonna get hurt up this motherfucker. Like, niggas gonna get hurt, but that's how they coming on. That's how you right.
Most dead.
Most dead.
Can't make this shit up, this shit the truth. I never let no rat inside my booth. But we don't fuck with niggas, seen the proof. My shooters trying to pop out and play ball, they trying to hoop.
I punch me in one take.
It ain't shit for me to pull up.
Skirt,
hop out. Niggas talking that gang shit to that chop out. Fuck these big niggas talking about, I got killers out on my smartphone. I scroll on my little nigga, he like 16 with a pole on him. Niggas told on him. My mud shots on case, man, I got a couple on him. My tennis shoes, they got buckles on them. I put my feet, my knuckles on them. Time about that pistol play. Time served on that murder case. Paperwork was on IG.
Oh,
thumbs up, smiley
shit.
Face. Bitch, I need Ben Frank face when I rolling all of my love letters. Broke niggas wanna switch place, so I ride around with that drum on me. Take a trip to my hood, nigga. Couple killers gon' shoot. Couple killers on poop. Nigga.
Dirty blood wanna clap face on the neck. I can't beat his ass.
CB had to call the police to open up the door,
cause I was on your ass.
Y'all called yourself trying to jump me. I spit in your ass,
drove you out to the lab.
I ain't never about to sleep in a cell with a nigga I beat up.
So I crashed, man.
Black kite through the air, blood gang on your ass. Had J-Rock with history, collect me 10 pounds and 70 cash. Talking level 5 penitentiary.
And any nigga ever play with me, I put my banger on that nigga.
Anyways, back to talking his money to Mexicans.
Yeah, I can go ahead and cut it if you want
me.
And
then start it again.
Just restart it?
Yep.
Okay. So you want me to redo that?
Yeah, just push the record button. No, just hit the record button twice.
Oh, okay.
Go and record that one. Okay. Let's go.
Alright. So, how was your childhood growing up in KC? Your siblings, experiences, your neighborhoods, all that?
Shit, like, I grew up 35th Jackson and shit, like, where I was at, it wasn't meaning, like, people on, like, our blocks. Been at our blocks, it's so many different blocks in one hood. Like, it ain't like most cities where you got 19 or 20 or 30 or 50 people from your block. It's not like that. It's like it'll be three of you from this block, one block over, it'll be four people over there, one block over, two people, one block over, five people, like, blocks. I was the block where it was only me. It was only me there.
Yeah, check the pitching and I'm back in the field. Yeah.
It was only me there. My big brothers, all them was older than me and shit by 3, 4, or 5 years. All my big cousins was older than me 3, 4, 5, 6 years. All my cousins that I did have that wasn't older than me, that was younger than me by 3, 4, or 5 years. Like, I'm gonna get somebody, whoever is accessible within the next, you know, I mean, days, couple days, like whenever, like, you know, we go out there to y'all, like whatever we gotta do, like to make it happen, cause it's gonna be like the whole story, like, you know, he'll ask a question, like, how was it with him growing up, or like shit that people wanna know and shit, and you know what I mean, I'm about to go into the movies, bro.
That sound about it.
Even though you're not able to be present, which you are gonna be present, I can do it where you, like, just talking to him on FaceTime and I'm recording it.
Yeah.
And you asking him questions. It's all
kinds of shit. Yeah.
So I was by myself. So like, I used to always have to walk around by myself, ride my bike by myself, walk to school by myself. I get into it with some niggas, I was by myself. So basically, I had to learn how to fend by myself. So that's how I was around my neighborhood growing up. My siblings, like I got two big brothers. My big brother Glenn, like he was always the best dressed. He was always prom king. He was always the most popular in the yearbooks. Move. Come here, get down. Kick. He all right. You ain't gotta cut it. I actually want my cats. That's my alter ego in there. As long as he don't knock it off. You understand, 6-0, I'm a 6-0. How you gonna be a 6-0 with no cats? But anyway, but go ahead. Next question.
All right, next question. All right, what were your parents like, and did they have any musical influence on you at all?
Damn, that's a dope-ass question. My parents, bro, crazy part about it, bro, the older I get, the doper I realize my parents was, bro. Like, but back then, they was even doper because I didn't know anything about anything except a working class. They work in and make sure that we got the things we want to need. As far as like musical influence, like my biggest fan, the person who motivated me, like that really pushed me to do it, was my mama. When I was like 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 years old, my mama, all my aunties come over and she'd be like, yeah, I know my son's singing and rapping now. All my aunties, all my uncles, all my cousins, I would have been embarrassed to be like, yo, y'all know. But she made sure every single person in the family knew and had to listen to it, had to listen to all the songs in the house. So that's how mine was. But my dad, growing up, my dad was listening to like all DMX, Tupac, Brother Lynch, Rich, Jay Diz, like all that tech, nigga, like all Bone Thugs and Harmony, like all that older shit. Like, nigga, and my pops, he was real big, like on having 15s in his truck. Like not no homemade shit, like going to shops and having them built in, the best speakers, the strongest, not no just vibration, like punches. And he used to always listen to heavy, hard-ass beats and shit. And the crazy part about it now, and it just came to my mind a couple of days ago, my whole life, I only can just listen to music. Music is my only peace, my only guidance, my only therapy, my everything. And it got to be loud as hell. And that comes from my pops. And it comes from the West Coast beats back in the days.
Stack that bitch up, mate.
Hey. Jamaican look Z type shit. Smoking on the rest. Running my city and killing the rat. Fuck on a bitch and it splat. Smoking on dope, this pack. East Coast, first bitch play get whack. Kill the rat, smoke roach. First bitch play bit whack. Nigga, first bitch play get smacked. Burn a little bitch, choke track.
You know what I'm saying? Like, we all deserve a chance to be not judged and be open to somebody and, you know, get to know that person, whatever they're about or whatever, you know what I'm saying? It's a fool to remix that shit, bro.
Most dead.
Yeah, for sure. All right, what about, man, your mom?
Sight Deaf, man. Shout out Sight Deaf and this motherfucker, bro. Flat out, bro. Appreciate you coming through.
Hey, man.
Pull up all to the city. Look, don't waste your time investing your time into people who ain't worth your time. When you pull up to the city of a motherfucker, oh shit, bro, why you didn't tell me about my knee, bro? Can you see my knee?
Nope, I don't got your knees.
Alright, bro.
You good, G.
Damn, bro, cause I can smack some lotion.
No, I got your belt, right, and that's it.
Alright, that's cool, bro. I appreciate you.
Yeah, bro.
Alright. Cause I could've easily fixed that up. Alright, that's cool. Alright.
Nah, you next good, question. G. What about your mom?
Mom's like, mom,
did she have a musical influence on you at all?
Mom's. Actually.
Or she was just a pussy.
Actually, mom's, that was the thing. Mom's didn't even listen to music, but what? She listened to my music.
Whoa.
And she listened to them every day, word for word. And I'm talking about ass quality, mixed craft.
Yeah.
No head.
Yeah, so she would hear you talk about the craziest shit, huh?
Now the craziest part about that is, when I first started, I got a YouTube channel right now that nobody knows about, all my music from 10, 11, 12, 13, when me and Waka was a group. In the beginning, we started off like doing R&B.
If I could get to know you, girl, I'd
want
to be gentle, so sweet. Keep you up loving me, baby. So you can get to loving me, shout out. Girl, you know I want you.
Like, we did R&B, we were singing, and we was rapping for the girls.
Mm-hmm.
Then we went around the age of 12, 13, then we went to dance, like dance music, boom.
Baby,
then like around the age of 16, then we went over to like drill rap, like went over to like drill, so like gangster music. So like, yeah, like if I give you the link to that YouTube channel, all my music back then, you'll be surprised. It's like R&B. Me, hey, talking to girls.
Bro, you was all about the ladies back in the day, so you ain't gotta tell me about that shit.
Baby girl, you mean so much to me. I'm like the door and you're the key, come open me.
Alright, okay. How old were you when you first found your love for music?
Good question. How old was I when I first found my... Bro. Do my hands look ashy on that camera?
Nah, bro, you
good. All right, bro.
You good.
It's okay, you say. Say it again.
How old were you when you first found your love for your music?
How old was I when I first found love for...
For music.
For music. I say about 2000... I say, let me just say this. Around my fifth grade year at Sanford B. Ladd Elementary School, I was asleep, and it was Lil Wayne's song came out. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Well, I was asleep, and it was and the alarm went off exactly at time for me to get up for school, and it was that song. But I was dreaming, and then literally that song had me thinking like that they was talking to me, like that was me, like that was like. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I thought that was me rapping that shit. I woke up and I'm like, damn. And then ever since then, that song right there remind me of me. And then that's when I grew a love for music.
That's tight.
Fifth grade year. Lil Wayne, Go DJ.
Go DJ. Man, that's crazy. That makes a lot of sense. Okay, do you remember your first song you ever wrote or your first project? And... when was your first show, and how what was your
first
experience?
First song I ever wrote. It was my fifth grade year in school. I never forget. It was like Valentine's Day or something. It was this girl named like Latoya Thorpe. Never forget her. I had a crush on her, so I wanted to write her a song, and I wrote her a song and I typed it up, and I had my big brother Glenn. I had him help me, you know what I mean? But that was the first song I ever wrote. My first project was actually after my mama passed away, I went to a place called like Ozenell Residential Treatment Facility. And I went to Ozenell. Come here. Sit down. I went to Ozenell and it was like an art teacher. It was like, man, a private school type shit. Man, I had like a computer teacher, and it was programs to record. And he told me that I can record. So when he told me that I can record, I actually started like putting together a project, which is on that YouTube channel I told you about with me and Waka.
Yeah.
But yeah, that was my first project. And then what was the other part of that question?
It's basically three part question.
Third part.
Do you remember your first song you ever wrote or your first project, and then your first show? Where was it, and what was your experience like?
Oh my Lord, my first show. Like my first show or like talent shows? Like,
nah, bro, your
talent show.
Yeah, whatever, show. Bro. Your very first show when
bro,
you
my
ever
very
performed.
My very first show ever performing was It was my eighth grade year at UCLA High School Urban Community Leadership Academy down north. I had a math teacher, and it was the math test. And then my math teacher, she knew I loved music. She was like, listen, if you can make a song about the math test, then I can make it, therefore you can perform.
What the hell? That's dumb.
I made the song about the whole class. I remember shit like S Divine in the back, you better not drop no pencil. I bet we gonna ace this map test, boom, boom, boom. Like, I remember like hella shit I said. But they let me perform it, and I recorded it at home. I actually went crazy. She asked for copies of the CDs. Everybody loved it. And to this day right now, my teacher was my health teacher. He was actually my basketball coach. He was my biggest fan back then.
This is running out of battery, G.
How low is it?
It's low. 20%.
That's cool for right now until we just get as much as we can.
Okay. All right. All right. Keep going. You were talking about the gym teacher.
My gym teacher. Yeah, he followed my platforms now and shit. But that was the first time he ever listened to my music back then.
So it was a school. You got to perform. That's dope as
Urban
hell, bro.
Community Leadership Academy down north.
Yeah. Okay. What places around Kansas City have you found the most inspiration?
Why you gotta kind of like explain it? I'm trying to understand that question.
Like, for me, if I go like downtown to Van Brunt, that's my inspiration because I came a little bit from there. You feel me? So I could walk through that neighborhood and be like, shit, bro. Like,
my inspiration is just like a viewpoint. I don't remember exactly where it said, but you can see over the bottoms. You can see over the whole bottom. Like, I took a picture down there before. But, it's a place. Basically, it's like the bottom or it's the viewpoint or something, whatever the fuck it's called. But
I explain it to people that don't know that I'm from Kansas City. You feel me?
All right, it's like a view where it's like a ledge, and you can walk over the ledge. If you look down, that bitch go down like 400, 500 feet type shit, all the way through trees, bushes, all the way to a highway down there. But you can see over the whole skyline of Kansas City, of downtown Kansas City and shit. You can see the whole entire skyscraper. And you go there late at night and shit, don't nobody be down there. But if you do, everybody be in different little corners where you can't see each other's. People go down there smoke. I like to go down there smoke. You know what I mean? Back when I used to, you know what I mean? I go down there drink and stuff late at night and I just look at the views. You know what I mean?
Okay. Let's see here. What artist influenced you or had your interest in Kansas, in the Kansas City music scene?
Okay, a lot of artists. Okay, let's say, first off, Willy Wonka, growing up, you know what I mean? Boss Tom most definitely influenced me about quality, taught me everything about quality to the business. Back in the days, all the TSG, the dudes from TSG, like when I was younger, I listened to them and I liked how they was different, like with their flow, they used to say different shit. They used to mix up different type of punchlines, you know, they was just different and unique. Tech Nine Business, like that's where I learned the whole business, like. Everything is business from Tech Nine. That's the GOAT of the business. That's the GOAT of the merch. That's the GOAT, you know what I mean? And that's who I learned. I learned a lot from Tech Nine. Richthefactor, I learned the CD game. And I really learned the numbers, how he can distribute a mixtape every week or every other week and drop these bitches at $25 a pop. And put them in the stores, everybody buying them, everybody respecting it, boom, boom. And I start doing the numbers. I'm like imagining hundreds of units. Imagining, you know what I mean, thousands of units. So yeah, most definitely big respect to Rich the Factor.
Shoot guys, we make a phone call, then we double back price, lay everybody down.
Bump. Wake the whole block up.
Bigkc better wrap up. Niggas ain't safe. We don't do attempts. We trying to close the case.
He don't do no attempts.
Niggas better wrap up. Niggas ain't safe.
Nike ski mask on. I'm trying to kill a bitch.
Body shot now.
Ride daylight. Fuck a witness. We don't do no attempts, we just be putting up shit. Nike ski mask on, I'm trying to kill a bitch. How about broad daylight, fuck about no witnesses. We got all the Drakeys, we get all them switches in. We got all the paper, niggas know what's up. Niggas know to wrap up when I shake. Crime scene, yellow tape. 357 Glizzy, can't fight that. Get your life snatched. Everybody got bodies where I'm from and you ain't like that. Slide for my dog, niggas be trolls. I got right back, straight like that. Attempt to break in my crib while I was gone, where they do that at? I need to invest in some gloves, cause on that mission I used a do-rag. Guess we gon' keep spinning till we get dizzy, we gon' do that. Why you got your outfit in on you for? Who you finna shoot at? Killacity, we wrap niggas up. We don't dap niggas up. We been picking up and dropping packages off. Niggas know what's up. I be acting slow as fuck.
That's what's up, man.
A man of many hats, a man of many personalities, a man of disguise, a jack of all trades, a king of all of that shit.
Okay, okay. Where did you find your influences and when?
When? Say it again.
Where did you find your influences? And when?
Okay. I'm at the phases and shit. My first influence and shit was my big brother Glenn and shit. See, he started rap all fast and shit, rap. And I wanted to motherfucking I wanted to rap and shit. So, like, that was way back when I was like 10, though. Like 10, 11, I was young. And all his friends was all the most popular people in the town, you know, all the TSG dudes, Knockafella, you know, I mean, just everybody, the most popular people and shit. So they used to come to my crib and shit, Collision, Click, Big Cuff, and them, all the popular people, but they was all older than me and shit. And I had a computer, a shitty ass studio, but I knew how to whip that bitch. So that's how I started getting around all of them dudes and shit, you know what I mean? When I was younger, but I wasn't like, you know, I wasn't fucking with the music and shit. Then I started getting older and shit. Wonka, my cousin Wonka and shit. Wonka always played pianos and was singing and shit. You know what I mean? So me and Wonka started doing music. I never wanted to rap, but he was always singing and rapping and shit, so I was recording them. And when I was recording them and shit, he used to always be like, put a verse on them motherfucker, I'll put some shitty ass shit. I'll go in them motherfuckers say some crazy shit, like some shit that I visualize, like I wanted some jeans and shit. I'll go in them motherfucking and said some shit about some jeans that I wanted, but I didn't have them, but ended up saying the same wrong name instead of him being like, yo, boy, hell nah. He's like, yeah, nigga, that's that shit, nigga, I'm my mama, nigga. And he made me record the song, we recorded. We go around everywhere, we pulling up on Manny, Bird, you know. We pulling up on Melonia, you know. Pulling up on everybody and shit. He letting them hear this shit. Everybody like, yeah, that's hard. And then everybody laughing and shit. I'm like, nigga, it's so funny and shit. He like, nigga, I ain't no motherfucking such and such 505, such, whatever the fuck I said. He said, nigga, now from now on, nigga, don't ever say nothing on the track, nigga, if you don't got knowledge of it, nigga. And then, but that was my motivation during that time. Like, my Wonka used to always tell me, like, nigga, nope, if you quit rapping, I'm gonna quit rapping. He's like, bro, we both gonna get dope, bro. Like, everybody loved him. Everybody hated my shit. They fast forward through my shit, skip my shit. Nobody fuck with my shit. My shit's horrible. Well, I could believe in me and shit. So the next phase was, that's when the quality come in, like Boss Tone and shit. My mama passed away and shit, and I started going out to Kansas and shit. And Boss Tone taking me to a studio. I think it's like Midwest something, you remember the name of that shit? Like Midwest Recordings or some shit. He took us there, me, Dorellos, Kim, probably like seven of us on one track. Couldn't believe it, we was in a real studio and shit. we ripped that shit up. But then that's when I realized, like, oh, shit, what was really going on? Like, yo, okay. And it made me start buying me studio equipment.
That white man don't get no fuck about your situation. These bitches lie, these bitches cheat, these bitches all ungrateful. I had to switch my swagger, can't keep catching these cases. Put my faith within a lie, trying to find my direction. Thought it was sacred, but you lied, nigga. Bullets glide, nigga. Homicides on my mind, nigga. I'm trying to find niggas. Get off that fence and pick your side, nigga. Or you gon' die, nigga. We gon' slide, nigga. Let's slide, nigga. By your side, nigga. They kill my cutty, I'm on fire, nigga. Keep my iron with me. I'm on your kids and your mama, nigga. About that drama, nigga. You gon' be ducking all kind of niggas. Don't want no problem with us. Fuck the feds, they out here lying. Niggas. Rappers trying to be us. I'm at the bank like I need racks now. I ain't backing down. Fuck the state, tell them max me out. Bet they pack me out. Fuck the judge, I'm a 4-1. 23-1. Come and get your fix. I got that skunk, nigga. Blowing runs, nigga. Speed down. I need it now, Brody. Right now, Brody. Shout out Chucky for that Mac 11. Bro, like what he taxing. He want 5. I'm on my way now with 31 rounds. Dicks on my line. I'm on my line too. Like what y'all trying to do? I think I lied. Made it out that jam. Cause I ain't know what to do. I ain't know who to shoot. Mellow dead. Walking the feds. Money on my head. Money making. Bitch, I'm out here caking. Money making Mitch, 100 bars. Call me one take. I crack in 5 states, 100K. I can get you straight, depending on where you stay. 10 bands, hit that liquid ace. That was back in the day.
When I went to prison and they sent me to St. Louis, camp was like 8 hours away from where I'm from. It was in the soul where I was from. So nobody listened to our music. Nobody knew a 2-Gun. Nobody knew a DV. Nobody knew a nothing in St. Louis. St. Louis don't listen to none of that. They feel like our music is doo-doo. They listen to the South. But that's where I was at a young age in my writing.
Ay, it was the bitch, her legs for me. Her pussy and head for me. It was the bread for me. The way she sleep for D. It was the nails for me. She pay the bills for me. She gon' kill for me. It be the pills for me. It be that kill for me. Bitch better not steal for me. It be her weed for me. Bitch ain't no leaving me. It was her titties for me. It was the gas for me. I couldn't see. It was her ass for me. It be that roll for me. Ain't no hole for me. Ain't no approach for me. Ain't no coach for me. Gang gon' blow for me.
Oklahoma, Memphis, Tennessee, St. Louis, Missouri, y'all know the vibes. Yo, nigga.
The niggas just be like, bro, that shit's ass, DJ. That shit's bump.
Yo, this is back in the door. This is back in the door.
Shut it down.
Don't see the door just like I thought. All that rabbit seats when I was released after being captured by the beast. I was a beast, but it's so equal, nigga. I'm too advanced, we ain't equal.
So what do you think about your craft is underrated?
Shit. When Nipsey dropped his first album, shit. How y'all is a pop. Everybody said he was underrated. All the DJs, all the outdated politics, all the internet, you know, specialists, all of his people and homies, they told him it was stupid. But look at Nipsey, he blew up because he believed in himself to sell this shit $100 a pop. It's like, I just listen to the people of them coasters and listen to them people, and I just give them what they want at this point, just give them what they want. Rather I'm underrated or not, and if I'm gonna pay. That's the best knowledge I can give on that. I kind of got cloudy minded on this shit.
Like,
what do you think about you? People underestimate the most. There, is that better for you?
Oh, okay. When people underestimate the most. Honestly, it's like I got this play slow, catch wise. Like mentality. What I mean by that, when people underestimate me, I just really everybody. I was the most underestimated in my city, but really I just looked at it like, shit, man. I know where I'm going. I know how I'm gonna get there. You know what I mean? And I realized that shit. Everybody in my city hate on Tech N9ne, and not one person in my city purchases CDs, so it don't make them or break them. So. look at me and look at them. Look at me and look at the artists that all the people I looked up to growing up, and all the people I wanted to be like, and all them people is exactly where we started.
What's the deal? Welcome to 2020 Vision Enterprises, LLC, where we connect the dots. We out here in Miami right now. We looking for all the local talent. You know, we looking to manage you. We looking to help you out. We looking to boost your career. Talk to me. I'm the man with the plan. Music videos, recording studio time, marketing, social media, branding, everything. Whatever you looking for, it's a one-stop shop.
Big step ups, brother mine.
Tell them come fuck with us. Or they can't fuck with us, you know.
You know the vibes.
Y'all
yeah, big step ups.
Would you consider yourself a performer, or do you just like making music? And what drives you on stage or behind your music?
So this was my first performance ever when I stepped foot in Florida. So you tell me, am I a performer, or do I just enjoy music?
I just like making music. I mean, I know how to perform, and I can put on the best performance you've ever seen. But when I'm performing, I don't really look at it as performing. I look at the art of the music that I wrote. Like, I block everything out, and I just hear the words, the beat, and I don't see nobody. So, like, yeah, I'm dope at it, but I just like to make music.
All right.
Life on the tracks.
All right. Do you want to be famous?
Shit. Crazy part is, I'm already famous.
No, my name's Sandy Cat, did like Randy. I don't know Shajah hoes, don't wear panties. I know a Zoe tossing Z's, Glock in his fanny. I know a bot named Sandy
Cat, did like Randy.
High speed from the Jakes, they gon' have to kill me.
Don't come around here thinking sweet, Florida hella trenches.
Z's will pop out and say cheese. When it rain, you better stay away from the trees.
It's just about to hit even harder and harder and harder and bigger. Like, do I want to be? Not really. I just want to just have enough bread and shit to be able to do whatever I want, however I want. I'd rather not be famous, you know, and have to pay. Shit. That's just what it is.
Just be able to take care of regular responsibilities through life and shit.
I want my people to be able to do whatever they want to do, however they want. Money is never, ever, ever a problem. For the basic necessities of life. Like, hey, I want to take a vacation and go see the ocean. This shit would be a problem.
Yeah, for sure. All right, last question. What is the ultimate goal for rapping ass DJ?
Ultimate goal for rapping ass DJ is use my platform, my artistry, everything that I do to teach everybody and shit, teach the next person, teach everybody the art. The most important thing is to make a way for 2020 Vision Enterprises LLC to be bigger than Death Row was, bigger than Strange Music ever was, bigger than YMBMC ever was, bigger than P. Diddy, bigger than any person to ever do it, like his own record label aspect, without not one piece of help from the record labels.
Hey, if Ron DMC them listen to this, Rakim, all them, MC Shine, all the young brothers too now. Everybody got their swag. But hey, this is the guy. Look for him. He's a hottie coming up. Tell our rappers, come up real quick. Take your time, though.
Respect.
Respect. Take your time. Get into some movies. That's where the money is at.
That's why look what we doing now.
Documentaries, everything. Get into the movie. Hey, excuse the way I look. I'm 53 years old.
Hey, you know, good, like, Pops.
Old OG. You know, hey, what's up? And word up to all my, I want to say what's up to my cousin Ricardo, all my cousins, Donnell M, all of them in Jackson, Mississippi. Lucky, especially my cousin Lucky, Jesse, all of them, Uncle Charles, R.P. to my grandma and everybody, his mom, much love all day long. Don't y'all never forget that.
All right. Thank you very much, brother.
Yes, sir.
You get any person to ever do like his own record label aspect without not one piece of help from the record labels. Not $1, not one piece of assistance, not one piece of reference. So therefore, what happened is now the record labels can't blackball me. Or the record labels can't try to kick me out of there. They can't do nothing. I mean, unless they doing violence and shit like that, that's something different. But what I mean, like, other than that, I got my own money. I pay for my own cameras. I pay for my own studio time. I pay for my own press. I pay for my own distribution. You know, I'm not under contract with nobody. You can't blackball and do shit like that. You know what I mean? And shit, you know what I mean? So, therefore, I can open up a door for all of the underground artists. First off, they respect what I've done for the culture. And then second off, willing to learn. And then now, we can go straight through the front door of the industry without the industry. You see what I'm saying? A lot of people gonna feel like, shit, I mean, fuck the industry. Niggas, the streets over there. Like, that's how I used to think growing up till I started learning the business. Once I start actually learning the business, I start learning it's just like anything else. Hustling houses, cars, drugs. It's really a business. And what are you in it for? Just to be local and rapping and die, be broke? Or you trying to get some paper? If you want to get some paper, you got to convert yourself into an artist. Not just a rapper. You gotta start investing in yourself, branding yourself. You know what I mean?
What advice do you have for any upcoming artists, my dude?
Oh man, you gotta be great, you gotta be bold. Fuck with everybody else, especially the sideline players. It's gonna always be the people on the sideline that's gonna say they're giving you the best advice, but look where they at. You know what I mean? If they can't, like, listen to the people that's successful in what they do. You know what I mean? Because listen, like really study it for yourself and take advice from people that's got progress or got motion or that's successful, because they successful at what they're doing for a reason. You know what I mean? This is what I could tell all the youth and upcoming artists and shit. Like, I could teach you how to own it all and shit. And your big homie and OG and shit around the way and shit teach you how to duck a bullet or run from the police and shit. You know what I mean? That's my advice.
All right, give us an outro, G.
Outro. All right.
This rapping ass DJ I got. There you go.
All
right.
I ain't never been the killer type. All I ever wanted was this skiller, right? 14 pitching ball, I'm talking all white. In the kitchen whipping hard, I'm talking all night. Alright, Jackie called me by my first name. Every time she caught, she bring me all change. Reno, that's my uncle, he'll never change. Smoking all that juice, be fucking up his brain. 411-93. I was born on 35th Street. I laced my clicks and hit the turf 2003. I started banging for the game, cheap and smoking weed. Got the plug on a prescription and started sipping lean. In 06, I stole a pit with my big cousin Steve. In 07, look at you. Yeah, one take DJ. Y'all know what it is. 2020 Vision. Yeah, 2020 Vision Enterprise LLC. Studio Dugout. Y'all know what time it is.
Boom. Gang.
Yeah. Psych.
All right.